Welcome to the SOTI video series. My name is Richard, a Senior Principal Instructor here at SOTI. We've previously linked Apple Business Manager with SOTI MobiControl, and in this video, we'll move on to the enrollment steps for iOS devices with automated device enrollment. Now that we're moving on to the device specifics, it's important to consider the source of the device. Now, the most streamlined route for adding a device through Apple Business Manager and enrollment through SOTI MobiControl is for the device to be purchased from a reseller. If the reseller is also registered with Apple Business Manager, it means that the devices can be purchased in bulk, that a reseller will add those devices into your Apple Business Manager, and you can find them easily and assign them to the MDM server that we've just created. This is the first option we'll look at. If you have devices that are already in your fleet that aren't added to Apple Business Manager and haven't been purchased through a reseller, there is a way to get them into Apple Business Manager through a tool called Apple Configurator, which we'll look at a little bit later on. But let's say I've purchased a device from a reseller. I can go to my devices area in Apple Business Manager, search for my device serial number, and I'll see my device here. And I can see it's currently unassigned from any MDM server. I'll select the device, click the three dots on the top right, and I'll choose Edit MDM Server. I'll select our server and click Continue and Confirm. Now, please note what this means is when this brand new device is turned on for the first time and connected to Wi-Fi, the device will reach out to Apple services and it will be told that this is a device that's going through automated device enrollment and it will be enrolling into this SOTI MobiControl server. Likewise, if this device is ever factory reset, it would go through the same process once it's connected to Wi-Fi. The device is now assigned to our MDM server, SOTI MobiControl, within Apple Business Manager, but there's one or two more steps that we need to do on the SOTI MobiControl side before we can provision our device. Within SOTI MobiControl, we start by going to Policies, Enrollment, and creating a new enrollment policy for Apple. In this example, we're looking at iOS and iPadOS automated device enrollment of Apple Business Manager, so I'll choose the iOS and iPadOS option. I'll give this a name. And I'll select our device type. Now, in this video, we're focused on company-owned devices that are being added through Apple Business Manager. So in this case, I'd select device, and as it says, we'll be using device enrollment to enroll company-owned devices. Next, we'll move on to our authentication and groups. This will be a device user authentication at the enrollment point. I can either say no, that I'm looking for no device-side authentication when the device enrolled, or I can click yes and either say somebody has to add their directory credentials or let's say a password as they're setting up the device. Next, I'll select our MobiControl device groups where this device will be placed. And then I'll say that this is an auto-enroll and link to our RocketCo server connection, which is our Apple Business Manager connection that we set up previously. From there, we can then review the general settings that enrollment is required, that we need to wait until the device is configured before the device can be used, that the device is going to be supervised, that the user is not able to unenroll the device, and there are other checks, including setting a minimum OS version if required. We can also configure what the user experience is going to be on the setup screen. So, for example, let's say we don't need the user to set up Apple Pay. We don't want them to, let's say, have access to location services. We can customize this as required, and only the relevant screens would appear as the device is going through its setup steps. For our purposes, I'm going to say absolutely everything is turned off, which should mean that the only thing that's requested as the device goes through its enrollment process is the Wi-Fi credentials and also that authentication password that I set on the previous screen. Finally, I'll click Settings. At the top, you'll see that there's an option called Activate Declarative Device Management. Now, this is one of Apple's newest features, and for the moment, I'm going to leave this enabled. But please check further videos where we'll look at this particular area in a little bit more detail. From there, I can specify the enrollment, the name of the device when it enrolls, the location of the device. I can even customize the wallpaper of the device as well, along with options such as whether there will be terms and conditions that the user needs to accept as they are enrolling the device. Once this is done, we'll click Finish, and this is our enrollment policy created. Now that this is done, we have two options about how this can be used. This could be our default enrollment policy that is applied to every single device that is added through Apple Business Manager, or we can apply it to specific devices based on the serial number. Both of these options are set up back in Global Settings. I'll go to Global Settings, Apple, back to our automated device enrollments. We can see our previously created connection here. Now, if I'm looking to have a default enrollment policy so that all iOS devices that are linked to this server on Apple Business Manager use this policy by clicking on the three dots on the right-hand side and say set default policy. And for example, I can say that our default iOS policy will be the enrollment policy that I just created. This particular route is beneficial for, let's say, if you have one staging folder which all your devices will be placed into and they move to their end location at a later point. To be more specific, however, we could say that we're looking to sync the devices and assign particular devices to particular SOTI MobiControl enrollment policies. To do this, we can select this sync device option. This will sync the devices that are allocated to our SOTI MobiControl server on Apple Business Manager, and then I can click assign. And you can see that our device, which we allocated to our server on the Apple Business Manager side a few minutes ago, is displayed. And I could copy the serial number and say for this specific device is going to be enrolled to the Rocket Co. device enrollment policy. I'll add the serial number, click assign, and there we have it. So those are two routes, either a default policy that all devices use, or we can be more specific and synchronize the devices that are added to our server through Apple Business Manager and then assign them to specific MobiControl enrollment policies dependent on our needs. Thank you for joining this video where we have worked through the enrollment steps for iOS devices with automated device enrollment. We've seen how this can be achieved between Apple Business Manager and SOTI MobiControl. In the next section, we'll see the device side enrollment experience. For further tutorials, visit and subscribe to the SOTI YouTube channel. And for more information about the SOTI One platform, visit SOTI.net.